Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
There was some respite for homebuyers of the Amrapali group when earlier this month the Supreme Court stepped in and said the NBCC has to complete the project. But really, should the homebuyers get their hopes high, and what is the status as far as NBCC is concerned, is what we are going to look at in Government Matters today with me, Ruhi Tiwari. In conversation with me is Moshmi Das Gupta, who's also done an exclusive story on this today. Please log on to theprint.in to read her story. Moshmi, you know, just to give a brief to our viewers about what really happened in the Supreme Court, just a few seconds, if you could tell us, what did the Supreme Court say? What was the problem with the Amrapali group?
On July 23rd, the Supreme Court, while hearing the Amrapali case, which is hearing the Amrapali case, gave a judgment cancelling the registration of Amrapali group of companies under the RERA. And while cancelling the registration, the Supreme Court also came out with a plan about how NBCC, the government builders, the government's real estate developer, is a public sector undertaking under the administrative control of Housing Ministry, how it is going to finish the construction in the remaining flats, and from how it is going to arrange funds.
Right. Now, you know, I know that this, at that point, as I mentioned in the introduction, would have come as a bit of a relief for the home buyers of these projects. But really, should they be relieved? What is the status of funds as far as NBCC is concerned? Because this is, it's not, you know, you can't just make houses like that. You do need funds. But what is the status of the funds?
See, the Supreme Court stepping in, of course, has given a ray of hope to home buyers,
right,
who till now were running from pillar to post, because many of them have invested their life savings and they have bought, some of them have bought flats way back in like 2008.
Absolutely.
But till now, they haven't got the possession of their flats. So, in that case, the Supreme Court stepping in is a huge relief. But then, the home buyers still have a long way to go before they can actually get possession. Because, like you said, funding is one big challenge. So, when the Supreme Court was hearing the case last year, it had ordered, on the direction of the Supreme Court, an escrow account was set up where money would be deposited from, you know, selling of Amrapali's assets, from all other sources. The money would be deposited in this escrow account, from where it will be disbursed to the NBCC for constructing the project. NBCC had made it clear that it will just be a project management consultant.
It will not put in any funds of its
own. No, it will just execute the project, but it will not put in money from its own pocket.
Right.
So that's why this escrow account was created, from where money collected from, you know, recovered from all sources, including, you know, selling of unsold inventory of Amrapali, would be
right,
deposited and dispersed.
Right. Now, Moshmi, how much money is there in this escrow account, and how much more is needed to complete the project?
The escrow account right now, as of now, has just rupees 19 crore in its kitty, while the NBCC believes, the estimate that it has prepared is, it requires something around 8,500 crore to complete the 4,600 flats.
So that, so means what? That is what percentage?
That's just 0.2% of the funds. But having said that, on July 23rd, the Supreme Court in its order had listed out the different avenues from where funds would be collected for this Amrapali project, and if the money comes in from all those avenues, it would be to the tune of 11,320 crore. So, and NBCC has estimated 8,500 crore. But the fact is that the sources that has been listed, I mean, recovering money from those sources, it's a very complicated process. It's a time-taking process.
Can you tell us some of those sources? I mean.
Yes, for instance, the court has listed that the court has directed all the home buyers who have pending dues to clear all their dues within 3 months. That comes to something around 3,200 crore rupees. But then, most of the home buyers in the Amrapali project, they had made the payment as per the construction linked plan,
right,
where you pay the money based on the progress of the construction.
So step by step.
Step by step. And they are not liable to pay money till the construction is over.
Right.
So, I mean, how and why will they make the payment before the construction is complete?
They'd also be afraid to, considering they've already made
yeah,
so much payment.
So where is this 3,200 crore going to come from? Then the court has also said that there are a lot of Amrapali's unsold inventory. So, if you sell those off, you will get something around another 3,000 odd crores.
Right.
But then, who is going to sell off the flats, the court has appointed a receiver, but you know, before you get down to brass tack, I mean, it's going to take time. So where are you going to get that money from? Then the court has said that Amrapali, the people, the management of Amrapali had diverted home buyers' money, and that is again to the tune of some 2,500 odd crores, and those money would be recovered. So how are you going to recover those money?
It's a complex process.
It's a very complex process. So I mean, all in all, I mean, it's not going to be easy way. Though the court has said that it can recover money to the tune of 11,000 crores, but it's riddled with complexity.
Right. Now, Moshmi, NBCC had been handed over other Amrapali projects earlier as well. What is the status of that?
Last year, in the same case, the Supreme Court had, Supreme Court was hearing. So, in January, the Supreme Court had, as a test case, asked NBCC to complete two unfinished projects of Amrapali, the Eden and the Eden Park and the Castle project. Right. So those are these two are projects which are like 85 to 90% complete, and just very little amount of work is left.
Which is the last leg.
Yeah. So as a test case, the Supreme Court asked NBCC to complete the work. And the Supreme Court, and they had estimated that it will require something around 10 crore rupees to finish the work. So for that, the Supreme Court had disbursed just 1.5 crore to NBCC. This was sometime early this year. Right. And because funds were not forthcoming, so NBCC from its own pocket had put in another 1 crore rupees. But then because the courts got closed, the money did not come. So they eventually stopped work on the two projects. Though NBCC, the government sources are telling us that NBCC has submitted a bill to the Supreme Court, and now that the courts are open, the money would be, you know, refunded. But the fact is that, you know, for a project of 10 crore, you get just 1 crore, and then NBCC, it's a test case, and NBCC stopped work.
Right. So Moshmi, in that sense, in the test case, NBCC had to stop work. For the current case, there is, as you mentioned, only 0.2% of the funds currently available, and the methods of recovering funds are very complex and long drawn. Where does that leave the home buyer who, as we've talked about earlier, may have invested her or his life savings in purchasing this house?
Well, for the home buyers, the only thing is that now it will be, I mean, everything is monitored by the Supreme Court. So, you know, there is hope that they will get possession of their flats. But when, nobody knows as of now. It's going to be a long drawn process, like I have said earlier. And one will have to wait and watch. Also, despite the Supreme Court giving its judgment on July 23rd, it's because of all these peripheral issues involved. Like, I mean, why would home buyers pay money if it's a construction linked plan? So to take up this peripheral issue, the Supreme Court is hearing the case again on August 9, where hopefully they would pass some more orders to, you know, help the home buyers and to kind of clear this whole confusion about funding.
So to end, just before we close, Moshmi, there is also something to be said about why the government would step in to complete a private party's mess, you know, and to sort that out, because that's what's happened with the Amrapali project. So what is the thinking in the government, in NBCC, on this?
Well, the NBCC stepped in because in this case, the Supreme Court roped in NBCC because, you know, they have built projects, they have expertise. But in this case, NBCC, is not putting in its own money. Yes. But NBCC is getting a 8% consultancy charges because they are the project management consultants. Yes. So they're not putting any money from their own pocket. But this is just one case. NBCC has also shown interest to take up unfinished projects of JP Infratech, which is presently, I mean, going on in NCLT, and the Unitech projects also. So, for instance, in JP case, the NBCC's proposal, the earlier proposal was that they will take up the project, they will monetize JP's asset, and the money that they raise from there would be used to finish the unfinished projects. Right. So, they are saying that that's how they are going to get their revenue from. But then, again, the whole thing depends on, it's a very complicated case, NCLT's order, whether JP would win the bid or not, if there is some other bidder. So
a complex process, as you said. Well, a long way to go for home buyers of the Amrapali group. As Moshmi pointed out, paucity of funds is the biggest challenge, the biggest concern, and the only hope for them and the respite for them is that the Supreme Court is involved in the exercise, so there could be some light at the end of the tunnel. Thank you so much for watching Government Matters.